Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial for RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to use this Sharp Infrared 0A51SK distance sensor that measures up to 15 centimeters using Arduino. As you can see, we are at around 7 centimeters and we are reading that 7 centimeters. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. You can use this with Arduino Nano, any Arduino that you have. The code that I've written will work with 3.3 volts and the 5 volts Arduino version. The code that I've written for this is for multiple of these, because we know in robotics you will need more than one of this, so the code is accommodating if you have multiple of this, as long as the input of your Arduino, for example in this one allows 6, but if you are using larger Arduino with more analog inputs, you can do so. This module is widely used in many robotics applications and for shorter distances. There are different versions of this and I have separate video explaining those, but this version particularly is used between 2 centimeters to 15 centimeters, and it can be used in robotic arms, small moving robots that you need to measure the distance. It can be attached 4 of this. We can attach one here and one or two maybe on this side, two on this side, and one at the back, so your robot will be aware of the surrounding distance. You can use it for many other applications. So how this function is that we have an infrared emitter and infrared receiver, so the signal emits and receives back, and proportionally we have a voltage at the output, and this can operate with 5 volts. And we have only 3 wires. The red will go to the VCC, this goes to the ground, and this is the signal which we are reading the voltage. And because we have analog input with Arduino, we can read the voltage, and proportionally we can calculate the distance. And I've experimented with the values. I've measured from 2 centimeter up to 15 centimeter, and then I measured the voltage. From this, I've created this plot. The blue is the value that I've done, and then the red is the equation of the line, the fitting line that is fit on this equation, and here we got the equation. Use this equation in the calculation that I've done. I will also provide you this table in case if you need it. Length of this is 27.1 millimeters. Width is 10.8 millimeters. Depth of this is 11.8 millimeters, but of course there is a connector. But if you want to create a space for this to fit it in something, the length is 19.1 millimeters. The width is 7.9 millimeters. And here is a data sheet for GP2Y. So this is the most important part, A51S0F, A51SK0F. And this is from Sharp. So this is the block diagram, how it works. We have an emitter that emits. This is the emitter, and that is the receiver which receives it. And the voltage will be proportionally outputted. The full specification is here. The operating voltage is from 4.5 to 5.5 volts. Here at 15 centimeter to 2 centimeter, we will be getting 1.35 to 1.95 volts. And the current that it needs is 12 milliampere. So keep that in mind. Maximum will be 22 milliampere in case the battery matters to you. I will provide you this data sheet. This plot is here, and because I've started with 2 centimeter, I was not worried before that, so I've started from here and I got almost the same type of plot, but mine is very accurate because I did it practically. And here I'm measuring every step from 2 centimeter to 15 centimeter and recording them here, so I can create the formula and get the equation of the plot from here. Now let me explain the wiring. We have here three wires. This will be connected to 5 volts. This is connected to ground. So fortunately, they follow the convention by putting red for 5 and black for ground. And this, you might get it yellow or white, doesn't matter, but this is the signal, the voltage output. They did not have this pin header, but I saw that. Here is how I've connected it. The red is connected to 5 volts. The middle, the black, is connected to the ground, and the white is connected to analog 0. Of course, you can select any other analog that you want. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Now let me explain the code. I've kept in mind that you can use multiple sensors, and here we are defining an array for pins. I used analog 0. If you're using more than that, then define the pins here, for example, analog 1, analog 2, or so forth. But this is the distance that is holding this variable, this array is holding the distance for each sensor. So because I have only here, because I had only 1, I put here 1. But if you have here 2, for example, if you have analog 1, then because we have 2 elements, you must put here 2. Otherwise, you will get errors because they must match. This line is average of 50 measurement to get accurate value. And this is a microcontroller unit voltage for if your Arduino is nano or other version that are 3.3 volts, please enter here 3.3 volts. Because I'm using Arduino Uno, it is 5 volts, so I put 5 volts. Inside the setup, we initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and in here, if you come here to the right, to the lower section, you will see 9600. This must match, otherwise you will not be able to read it. Inside the setup, this is a function that is going to measure the distance, and this 0 means the first sensor. If you have the second sensor, put 1, 2, 3, but start from 0 as many as you have. Because now I have only 1, so I put 0 here. So keep that in mind because it starts with 0. And here this line is printing the text D1 with equal sign. And then this is printing the distance because we are reading distance 0. So that is for the sensor 0. And this is just printing this text from here, and at the end I've just added this centimeter inside the double quotation. This function is in here and it is calculating the average and returning the value. And you say read distance and you pass a value 0, 1 or 2. So this number, the number that you pass, will become sensor voltage temporary average. So this is a variable that we use to hold the average values. And here we use analog read sensor pin, and we get this value that we pass here. This sensor comes here and it goes and picks up the value from here. 0 means get this one, 1 means get the other one, and so forth. So this gets the sensor pin, and this reads from that sensor pin. The value for this will be stored here. We call it sensor value, and the value will be between 0 to 1023 in 10-bit system. And we have 1 millisecond delay, so give it enough time to read. And then we get this value, which is this one, and we multiply it by 5 over 1023. This 5 is a 5 volts of operating voltage of the Arduino, and 1023 is a number. It is 2 to the power 10, which is 1024 minus 1, so it becomes 1023 steps. So we are dividing the 5 volts by this many steps, and we get a factor. When we multiply it by this sensor value, you get a voltage. And then we are adding that calculated voltage, adding it to this variable. So we are adding by this number. Average of is a variable that we defined here, 50 average of. So we are getting 50 calculations and adding it. Now it will be a huge number, but in this line we are getting that average and then dividing it by average of, dividing it by number of iteration, which is divided by 50, so we get the actual average. And using this value, and then we use the average calculated value to insert it into this equation of the line, to the fitting equation, and then this value will be stored in the variable called distance at this location. If this is 0, it will be for the sensor 0. If it is 1, for it will be for sensor 1, and so forth. So this is just updating this value, which is in here. I'm attaching the distance, the sensor here on this box, so it stays stable. And at this point, so this is the sensor, and it's exactly at 0 millimeter. This is a millimeter range. And here this is 6 centimeter. At this point, that's the edge, and we are reading 6 centimeter. Let me go to 3 centimeters. And here we are reading 3.1. So 2 centimeter. We're reading 1.89. Let's go 10 centimeter. And we are reading 10.18. Let's go further. So 14 centimeter. At 14, we are reading 14.1, 14.3. And this is the edge where after this you will get incorrect reading. Reading 15.3, which is correct, but 14.5 is not fluctuating now. So if I go to 18, now this is unreliable. But if I go with 11 centimeter, seven centimeter, it's very accurate. But it has some deviation because it's infrared, and also it depends on the surface. If you use a very shiny surface like this, let's see what we read at 11 centimeter. Actually, we are reading not bad. 9 centimeter is 9.5, 9.3. So when I put a glass, it disturbs the reading because it has magnifier. And let me put a mobile phone with very shiny surface. So we are reading 14, even though we are at 11. So you need a very non-reflective surface to get better measurement. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this sharp infrared distance meter with Arduino.
If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe.
In this tutorial, we are going to learn and test this VL53L1X time of flight laser sensor with range of 4 meters. This module is offered in this shape, and so we are reading 3 meters. And let me point it to the further away on the wall.